Josh, congrats. Keep it going against Carolina Forest. And obviously, the first thing I want to talk to you about is you got to christen the stadium, although it was raining, but you still had a good turnout. Talk a little bit about finally getting to play in the renovated, beautiful new Wildcat Stadium.
It was great. It was great for our kids to be back at home and to get to play in their home stadium. And it was really good for our school and our community to be able to get back out and experience Lexington football at home, finally. And the stadium was beautiful. And it was raining, but it wasn't a hard rain, so it was good. I wish we could have inhabited the press box. You know, we couldn't go into the press box because it hadn't passed inspection and all that yet. But hopefully it'll pass this week. We'll be able to use the press box. But it was a good night for our kids, a good night for our school and our community.
Were you able to use the Jumbotron since you weren't in
there? Yes, we were able to use the Jumbotron. That was about the only thing. Other than the new entry, it was the only thing we were able to use.
Okay. This week, homecoming week here, maybe a press box, and hopefully not rain. I think we've had enough of that. You've got Lugoff Elgin coming in. Is homecoming, just talk a little bit about that. Is it a distraction for high school or not really, or for your guys?
Yeah, I think it offers a lot of distractions for your kids to be caught up in, but we've got a good group. We've talked to them all week about staying focused on the task at hand. We talk to them all the time about a Zoom focus, making sure they're focused on what they're supposed to be focused on. So, but at the same time, you're talking about 15, 16, 17-year-old kids. So hopefully we'll have a good crowd out here Friday night. It is homecoming, so we encourage all our Wildcat fans to come out and pack the stadium out and make it a good atmosphere for our kids. Hopefully our fans and our school will do that. But we've got a good Lugoff Elgin team coming in here, so we're going to have to play well.
As far as you guys go, you just seem to be getting better and better. Since that opening game, you haven't lost. And obviously getting Trey Mitchell back at linebacker has just been huge for your defense. And you're telling me that this past week, as he came back from being out early with an injury, mm-hmm. or with a medical situation, he kind of looked like the old Trey, 16 tackles.
Yeah. Yeah, he's getting back to playing the way that Trey's always played, and he'll get better each week. And this is really only his third game back. So, but he had 16 tackles, was all over the field, and he's our leader on that defense, gets us lined up. He's like a coach on the field. I mean, he's a very, very bright kid, very smart, very heady football player. So having him back has been really good for our defense.
And again this week, defensive end Mason Malden, huge, 12 tackles, I think, had a sack. And you said he's really dominating play.
He has. He's played extremely well for us the past 2 weeks. And really, Mason's turned in some really good individual efforts. But that defensive line as a whole, with Jalen McCoy and Matthew Boring and Dylan Cripe and Andrew Harmon, that group as a whole has played tremendously well. And that's what's allowing Trey to make his plays at linebacker. They're doing what they're supposed to do. And that the defense as a whole has played tremendously well the last few weeks.
Obviously, the rain last Friday made it difficult to throw the ball as much as you usually did. But again, it all starts with Slade, and I think he came through with 147 yards, 3 touchdowns. Yeah. So you really didn't need to throw it around that much, did you?
No, we didn't. Slade, he ran the ball hard, but those guys up front did a great job. And like we talked about before, that group's getting better and better every time they go out up front, which is only going to help Slade out. And then, once Slade gets going, it only helps our passing game out. So the elements weren't what we wanted them to be Friday night. We were still able to make throws and do some things when we needed to. But really proud of that group and how we ran the ball, how we blocked up front, and Slade doing what he does every week, playing well.
Can you feel that you're getting closer to the region play? Of course, that begins a week from Friday. Do you kind of feel that? Is it in the air?
Yeah, you can. We talk to our kids, and we kind of approach the football season in three phases. You got your non-region schedule, which we're getting close to the end of here, your region schedule, and then your playoffs. And we talk to them all the time about it's a marathon. It's not a sprint. Mm-hmm. We want to be playing our best football late in the year, especially when we start here in region play. So, we got one more opportunity to go out and work on doing what we do, perfecting some things and getting better at what we do before region play starts next week. So hopefully that's what we'll do Friday night.
Kind of crazy that at least regular season-wise, after you play Friday, you'll be over halfway through the regular season. Yeah. Boy, it goes fast, doesn't it?
These first 6 weeks of the season has flown by.
I got to ask you real quick and sit right there, but I see you have this. Looks like you bought it at a memorabilia show. You got Brett Favre's Shrine Bowl jersey from back in Mississippi. So where'd you pick that up?
Yeah, that was back in the day when I could actually move around and play.
Oh, that's yours?
Yeah, I think I got a picture in there.
Oh, okay. Well, that, congratulations on that. I had no idea.
A long time ago.
Hey, seriously, what a nice to have been. Not that you had your twin, obviously, playing wide receiver back in the day, but, boy, what would it have been like to have your group of receivers that you have here as a coach to throw to?
Yeah, that group's special.
Back on Friday night.
We've talked about that as a staff, that group as a whole, five or six of them, they can play. So we're very lucky to have that talented of a group.
All right, Coach Favre, Coach Stepp, appreciate it. And good luck on Friday, man.
Thank you.